Cricket Adda presents Swing and Seam.
Okay, and hello and welcome back to Cricket Adda presents Swing and Seam, episode 4, The Main Threat.
So what is the main threat when India travel to England?
Obviously, swing and seam. India are going to face a lot of trouble, a lot of... it's going to be very hard for India. It's going to be difficult against the swing and seam, the difficult English conditions as we talked about throughout this series.
So when overseas teams travel to India,
yeah,
India make out, dish out some turners,
yeah,
and all teams struggle, and then it's Ashwin and Jadeja coming above everybody else. But when India travel overseas, everybody do the same thing. When India travel South Africa, South Africa dished out some green wickets, and the third test match had a terrible wicket,
yeah,
with all the pace and bounce and terrible bounce and everything. If India play on such wickets, will India be in trouble?
Yeah, India will be in trouble, obviously, because they've got two world-class bowlers. There's no doubt about them. James Anderson, Stuart Broad.
900 test wickets between them. That's the same.
Yeah. So, the two world-class bowlers, you take the third bowler. Yes, we talked about in our last episode. It's a bit of a weakness for them. But Chris Wokes, a brilliant swing bowler.
And if Ben Stokes is available, he too is a good bowler.
Ben Stokes is there. You've got someone like Sam Curran, Tom Curran. They're English bowlers. They know the English conditions, obviously. You've got someone like Mark Woods, Craig Overton. They're all brilliant bowlers. Good swing bowlers. But the main threat is obviously Anderson and Broad. How will India play against these two swing bowlers? It's going to be difficult because the last time in 2014,
That's the main point here. Now let's have a look about how the Indian batsmen fared in 2014. On your screen, Virat Kohli's stats, absolutely terrible.
Yeah,
10 innings, 132 runs at an average of 13.2. You don't expect from a top order batsman and a number 4 batsman, India's main batsman, these numbers once again.
Yeah, so obviously everyone talks about Virat Kohli's bad tour in England.
2014. Yeah,
so that will be in his mind as well, because he knows that was a very low point for him in his career. Probably the only low point in his career where he struggled very, very bad in England. But then again, when England came to India, he had clear plans. You know, he knew that he struggled against England, so he was leaving those outside balls.
And scored a double century, scored 167, scored a lot of runs
lot
against
of runs,
England.
Yeah.
When England,
that was a
India.
record series.
But remember, the ball wasn't swinging.
Yeah, the ball wasn't swinging. That's a good point. In England, the ball will be swinging. It's a very big weakness for almost all Indian batsmen. You talk about someone like a top order batsman like Shikhar Dhawan, he struggles big time against swing. You got someone like Cheteshwar Pujara, he struggles against swing. Probably the only batsman who is safe against swing is probably Rahane.
And Vijay.
Yeah,
Murli Vijay and Ajinkya Rahane, the two batsmen who did well against England last time when India travelled there. And you will be shocked to hear that Bhuvneshwar Kumar was one of India's highest run scorers. He was the third highest scorer, 247 runs. But now talking about India's number 3 batsman, Cheteshwar Pujara, you can see on your screen, 5 matches, 10 innings, 222 runs at an average of 22.2. Not good numbers once again.
Again, they're poor. You talk about Pujara, he had a county season in England. Again, very poor. Nothing to be excited about. I don't think there was
really dismal season for Pujara in the county circuit. So, Pujara, Kohli struggle against swing and seam big time. Now, Kohli hasn't had a county stint. He was going to play for Surrey, and due to his injury, he has missed out on some good county cricket.
Yeah.
So, will it harm India's
definitely,
chances?
Definitely, it will harm India. But then again, a good thing for India is that we'll be playing the T20 ODIs before the test match. We'll be playing also the T20 against Ireland before the test matches. So we will get a bit used to the conditions, used to the swing, used to the seam. Although ODIs, T20s, it's different. It's totally different. But again, the conditions, the pitches, they will get used to those, and I think India will be ready. I think there will be a game plan against the swing bowlers.
And another important point now, when India travelled South Africa, they didn't play a single practice game, but India are going to play some practice games. Some of the test specialists are going to join India A as well to play against England Lions for the 4-day games, which Karun Nair is leading the side. So maybe Vijay and Rahane are going to join there. Now talking about some new batsmen who are going to come in, somebody like a KL Rahul hasn't played in England, played two test matches in South Africa, wasn't at all impressive. What do you expect from somebody like KL Rahul?
KL Rahul, you can even talk about someone like Riddhiman Saha. I think it will be his first time. KL Rahul is going to South Africa. He struggled. And you know, we're not sure how he plays against swing. We haven't seen him play in England, Australia. He was
he scored 100, but the bouncy conditions rather than swing and seam.
Yeah, so swing conditions, we don't know how KL Rahul will play. We don't even know whether he will feature in the test matches, whether he will get a chance or not. But we all know Shikhar Dhawan, he played in 2014, he struggled.
He was dropped after the two or three test matches, and somebody like a Gautam Gambhir got a chance.
Yeah,
so you can see India don't trust somebody like a Shikhar Dhawan in those swinging and seaming conditions. So Shikhar Dhawan, Virat Kohli, Cheteshwar Pujara have to bring their A game if India have to do well in England.
Yeah, that is the biggest threat for India. Swing and seam against the Indian batsmen. They're going to struggle. We've got some new players. We don't know how that will go.
Yeah, somebody like a KL Rahul, somebody like a Riddhiman Saha, as you just mentioned. We just don't know how they are going to fare against those top class England bowlers in Anderson and Broad.
Yeah, but I think a game plan will be made.
Yeah, because, definitely.
Because we struggled in 2014. Obviously, the team management would have thought that we don't want to struggle this time. We want to win. We need a plan. We will be playing matches over there before. We will be playing practice matches. We will be playing one day. So the conditions will probably be better to know. You know, there might be a few grounds where India have already played one days and T20s. And again, they will be playing the test matches.
So that's a good point made there. India might get known to the ground.
To the pitch. Yeah.
Ground and pitch as well. And another important point is India struggled in South Africa as well when there were green pitches. India were not scoring runs at all, and that was the reason they lost the series 2-1.
Yeah.
So India have to score runs. Now the bowlers were doing well in those green conditions, and obviously they have to do well if the conditions are favoring them.
Yeah.
But the other point was their batsmen were failing.
Yeah.
So that's the main point India have to look after. If the batsmen can do good, India have a great chance this time.
So let's see what happens now. Few batsmen, they're struggling. Few batsmen are new, but most of them struggle against swing and seam. Let's see what happens in the India Tour of England test matches.
Just a point to note, this is Virat Kohli 2.0.
Yeah.
He is not that 2014 Virat Kohli.
Yeah, yeah,
He's definitely will be tested, but he will have an answer, I guess.
Yeah, he will have an answer. Let's see what answer Indian batsmen have after that poor 2014 tour. So, thank you for that. Concludes episode 4 of Swing and Seam. So the main thread. So thank you for watching this video. If you liked our video, please like, share, subscribe, comment, and keep on watching Kriya Adda. Keep on watching Swing and Seam. Next episode next Friday.
And that's about India's tour of England again. It's the build up, Swing and Seam, the main thread. Thank you very much.